Lisa, this is take six. We're here in Australia. We heard the awful news about Tony and breaks our hearts. We just want to send a message to you and to the Drake family that we're praying the comforter to you to comfort you and comfort everybody. We had a chance to meet Tony during the Las Vegas shows, and he's become family to us. Now we are a family to you as he's laid to rest. And we just want to send you this message.
You can come as you are, as you are, full of heaven applause. Only one type of blood
in the family of love.
Oh, family of God.
Hi Lisa, how are you? I extend a warm hello to you and all our mutual friends at this wonderful event for Tony. I am so sorry that I couldn't be there. I'm so far away. But rest assured, my thoughts and sympathy are with you, and I'm there in spirit. You know, I could say a lot of great things about Tony, but I'm sure they've been said already by lots of folks, and he's such a wonderful, wonderful player, blues player. And he'd make the guitar talk in his own language. And what a great musician. So again, I'm so sorry that he's gone, but he won't be forgotten. Anyway, hard to believe that Tony's gone, but like you said, we have to celebrate his life. He's such a great guy. He touched so many people. You know, every time I talk about Tony, I tell folks about the first time I met him. I was standing by the rail at the Bootlegger, and they had just finished up, and he was walking down that side aisle by the bar, and he had his guitar under his head down, and I happened to be standing there, and he looked up, and he said, "Hey man, I know who you are." He said, "I saw you on my tube." It really tickled me. And wait a minute, you saw me on your tube or my tube? He said, "Oh no, I saw you on my tube." From that point on, I knew we'd become good friends. Anyway, and we did become good friends, as you're well aware. So, again, my condolences, but celebrate Tony's life. And I'm going to add some pictures onto this. I'm going to have my videographer here in the studio add a few pictures onto this video from when I delivered Tony's guitar. I'll never forget it. He lit up like a Christmas tree. He was so happy. So enjoy these pictures, and while the photos are displaying, there was a song that I wrote, a solo piano piece for my father when he passed away, and it's somewhat of an elegy, a solo piano piece. It's on the Jazz Quintet album from 1981, and Mike Wofford, who's one of the world-renowned jazz pianists, is playing the solo piece. So please enjoy it, and have good memories, and I will. I'll always remember Tony. He may be gone, but he's not forgotten, and he'll be well-remembered very fondly. Bye now. Thank you.
Just as one.